Good afternoon. Welcome to J-Town, Jakarta, Indonesia. This is the FIBA Asia Cup and it's the qualification for the quarterfinal between China and Indonesia. And you don't get any bigger games than this, certainly for the fans of Indonesia. We also have these qualification for the quarterfinal games, Jordan, Chinese Taipei. That'll be next tonight. Then tomorrow, of course, Japan against the Philippines. And wrapping things up, New Zealand against Syria. Well, I'm Jeff Taylor, and I'm joined by Mark Mills, just like I have been this entire FIBA Asia Cup. We've been here for the entire ride, just you and me and nobody else except all these incredible fans. And we have been living the high life. It has been an incredible tournament. And again, it doesn't get any bigger for Indonesia.
No, it truly doesn't. And you're right, this tournament has given us game after game that has been absolutely sublime, plenty of twists and turns. And as we see China introduce maybe a team that hasn't had the smoothest ride, they've certainly experienced the most twists and turns, but they have grown each game. They've developed to move forward. And they are entering today's games clearly as favorites. They have a roster that can contend for that gold medal. But they need to show it on the floor right now because they haven't had a 100% convincing game so far in this tournament.
And the main reason why, not only are Indonesia treasuring these experiences in international basketball and playing at home, they're desperate, they're praying that they're gonna put their best game out there to give them a chance to win this game, because if they do, it's not just getting to the quarterfinal, it's qualifying for the FIBA Basketball World Cup. They need to get to the quarterfinal if they are gonna take up one of the host spots for the World Cup. Indonesia, Jakarta, one of the host nations for the FIBA Basketball World Cup, along with Japan and the Philippines. So we've seen a lot of good things from Indonesia. They got a win on opening day against Saudi Arabia. They weren't quite as good against Jordan, obviously, and also against Australia, but we've seen some really good things. It could be a very interesting game against China. Now we're gonna have a pause for the playing of the national anthems.
Please remain standing for the national anthem of Indonesia.
Absolutely fantastic for these games for Indonesia, and you can see some of the billboards or the signs
talking about you got to win this to get to the World Cup. And one thing that you can't say about Indonesia is they have definitely given it their all. And without question, their Michael Javiero, one of the terrific talents in this tournament. He'll be going to Grand Canyon University this coming year. Not far from now, he'll be moving to the United States and playing basketball for Grand Canyon. They've had a lot of good international players there, so I'm pretty sure he's going to be a big success there and ultimately a big pro. But Joji, of course, is back with China. We saw him back against Chinese Taipei, and that's what everybody's talking about. China, just a different team when he's out there. They've also got Wang Jolin, but Joji just is on the defensive end especially, just makes all the difference. And the referees for today's game, lining up from Kazakhstan, Yevgeny Mikheyev in the middle there, with some Zane from Kuwait, and also from Syria, and Mohammed Alamiri from Kuwait. So he is on the left. And we'll look at the starting fives. Any thoughts, Mark?
You're absolutely right. Joji, when he's on the floor, China look very, very different. It makes things a lot easier for them on the offensive end. Expect him to have a bigger game than he did in the last one.
Okay, so Sun Mingwei, Zhao Rei, Gu Huan, Wang Jialin, and Hu Mingxin in the starting five today. So Jai, Zhao, Fan, He, Fu, all these China players, Hu Shaning, Fu Hao, Jiang Weizhou, a very important player, and of course Xu Jian coming off the bench for the coach, Coach Du, Du Feng, former player, now the coach. And under a little bit of pressure here, I think. Also, Derek Michael Javiero, Brandon Van Dorn Chihuahua, Abraham Grief, Grahita, Andekar Pastawa, and Marquez Bolden in the starting five for Indonesia, the naturalized player. And then Coco Jeputra, Sapukera Norris, Kosasi Gonta, Wisnu, and Teja coming off the bench. And they're coming off the bench to play for that man right there. He goes Pejic. So, something like having to beat China in a do-or-die game to get to the World Cup. But I guess he's had his experiences in basketball. It's just another experience, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely is. But you're right. It's a big ask today for this Indonesian team to come out and win against China to secure that World Cup qualification. But I don't think it's beyond them. We've seen some breakout performances. Marquez Bolden has been phenomenal. Javiero has just really, really stepped up. You come sometimes forget he's 19 years old by the way he's played in this tournament. The concern slightly for Indonesia is, will their backcourt be able to contain the backcourt of China? China have a huge amount of talent in their backcourt. I think the frontcourts between the two potentially can cancel each other out. Foul trouble may be a concern within those frontcourts. But I have a feeling just the strength of the backcourt for China might prove a little bit too much for Indonesia to be able to contain.
There's Gu, scored the game winner for the putback against Bahrain. Otherwise, that shot that he made with, 6 seconds, had that not gone in, and had Bahrain in that second game, got the rebound, gone the other way, China would be going home.
It's unbelievable to think about when you look back to that point. That was a real meltdown game for China and certainly showed some frailties in the team. Their last game out against Chinese Taipei, they looked better, 95-80. I still don't think they're anywhere near the level they can play at. But they are going to have to start playing at that level soon, potentially here today, because they will be challenged by Indonesia. Indonesia, driven by this crowd, are not an easy task.
Yeah, they've been a little bit better than I anticipated, I have to admit. But, on opening night in Saudi Arabia, Marquez Bolden was unstoppable. In Jordan, they put the clamps on him. He still had a big game, but so did Derek Michael Javiero. And then against Australia, they were right with Australia, right? Through the first, 15 minutes. Then as they got to halftime, Australia started to get on top, and ultimately, predictably, the defending champions pulled away. But that's taken nothing away from the effort of Indonesia. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Jakarta, Indonesia. It's the FIBA Asia Cup, and it's the first qualification for the quarterfinal between China in the white, Indonesia in the black. And every
missed rebound, every missed layup, the shot will be cheered by Indonesia because they need everything to go their way tonight if they're going to upset China and make it not only to the quarterfinals but also to the FIBA Basketball World Cup. It will be staged here in Jakarta, also Japan, also Philippines next year. China out of the run. Inside to pull it back out. Well, these Indonesia fans, they know the word defense, but there's not much defense for the three-point shooter there, Chow Ray. Good meter behind the arc, launching that one up.
Indonesia, this is smart. Taking their time, being a bit more composed on the offensive end, I think is right for them.
And Marquez Bolden is not just a dunking machine, a swatting machine. He can step outside and shoot it, certainly if he's wide open. And he's not under any pressure. Bounce pass, Wong. Jolene travels, and already you see a little bit of a difference with Wong, who, in a sense, was like a bull in the China shot against Chinese Taipei and their big man. But Bolden presents a different challenge. It's much more of a shot block, I think, than William Martino.
Yeah, it's going to be a harder night for Wong, that's for sure. He had 17 points and 7 rebounds in that third round. If the Indonesian, they want a relatively low scoring game, if they can keep China to under 70 points, 70, 75 points, and I think they've got a chance of the win. Anything above that, it might be a bit too far for Indonesia.
Here's the drive and a swat. But the foul was called on the body before he got to the rim. You take away the inside game. Yeah, they call the foul on Javiero.
Yeah, it's the right call. Javiero just too much contact as he was driving to the basket. He also needs to realize that he has his partner in crime in the front court behind him, ready to protect that rim. Holden had swung around and swatted it away pretty easily, really.
Remember, Javiero is just 19 years of age. And just an enormous talent.
Yeah, truly is. You know, he set his stall out in this Asia Cup. He's seventh in rebounding, sixth in blocks, playing over 30 minutes a game at the highest level. I have a feeling he's going to be one of the icons of Indonesian basketball for a long, long time.
That was her, Ming Shin, making the free throws. Well, first all, they left them wide open, and he decided to go in for the layup.
Almost missed it. I think there was a few hearts in mouths in the arena.
It rolled around the ring a little bit, but just that little hesitation and Chinese defense switched off for him.
Sun pulls up. And they're going to stop play as Pastawa ties his shoes.
And Sun was one of those players, obviously in game two, that got himself ejected with the two technical fouls, but really came back and did a huge job in game three in against Chinese Taipei, 16.7 assists. And the thing that's even more amazing, even though he got ejected from the game, he's currently second in assists in the entire tournament. He's got 5.7 a game, makes them tick on the offensive end.
And the foul called on Sun out of the perimeter. The other player to be ejected was Chow Ray, number 8. And I think also it's interesting when you think about, okay, they played Australia in their last game. They didn't win, but is there a better warm-up for a game against China than facing the defending champions? They've already really faced the best, if you want to look at it.
Yeah, they've certainly been tested, and they didn't back down from that test. And, you know, that's more what I took from that game than anything, that they were up for the fight.
Pistala, curiously fouled by Wong. I don't know if he slipped into it.
Certainly didn't need to reach, did he? If he just extended and stood straight, there's no way Pristowa was going to shoot over him.
Why is he reaching?
Unnecessary.
He's like the Green Wall. You're not shooting over him. Oh, good defense from Wong. It's okay to reach for that.
And Coach Pezic there, trying to look calm on the sidelines, but I'm sure he's nervous as everyone else.
Cabrera shot it over the rim. Dude, wow, he's just dead-eye shooter, isn't he? What a shot!
Not just has he been dead-eye in this tournament, he's turned up at the right points. He's gone quiet and disappeared in certain stages of games, but when they've needed him, truly needed him, he's been there.
Good hustle from Javiero, but he couldn't chase the ball down in time. Bogusavis.
I kind of get, that's why I thought you said good hustle. I thought you were a little bit intimidated as he came up into the comms box.
Didn't want anything bad about it. Son and Degu, they share the basketball, and Wong fouled by Grajita.
And that's good play by China. Throughout, they were reacting to what Indonesia's defense were giving them.
Ooh, they're going to call a foul, hold
it. Yeah, I think they are, and that, if anything, is worth more than quite a few points on the floor if they can get some early fouls on either Bolden or Javiero. I mean, Bolden's quite lucky on that one, then.
Yeah, for the reach.
And this is certainly a weakness in his game, because 43% of the Asia Cup this year for Wong. It's all well and good having all the spin moves in the low post, and if you can't score from the free throw line as a big man, it's very limiting.
That's incredible, and now they get a layup, and that's almost unforgivable for Indonesia, because they had both Javiero and Bolden occupying those two spots.
That's fully on Bolden. Bolden just turned off. His brain wasn't engaged for that one. You know, that was, it would have fallen into his hands if he literally just stood and waited for it.
Toronto, tough shot off the glass.
And you feel now within the tournament is the time that Giuato needs to step up. He's had some good phases, but he truly needs a big performance today. He is that extra dynamic for Indonesia.
Son penetrates again. Wong gets in there. Well, he's already establishing himself as the main man in that low post. Quick play, and Gambita puts it up and in.
This is a pretty bright start from Indonesia. Clearly, obviously, losing the game by five is not where they want to be right now, but there's a lot of positive signs for them to build from.
Good from the right. Oh, boy, how good is he?
Looks like he's come to play today, and that causes a problem for Indonesia, because they're trying to overload in the paint to stop that front court pressure, and that's going to give him plenty of space.
A foul,
oh,
Javiero.
No. What a silly foul from Javiero. Absolutely crazy to commit that foul.
Two fouls now on Javiero, so he'll have to come out of the game.
It's completely unnecessary.
But sometimes I think youth perhaps doesn't serve him well.
You know, this will be the most intense emotional game that they've ever played within. So much at stake for Indonesia. Some players love it, some players buckle under that pressure.
Dare comes out and hits the three. And China open up their biggest lead, 20-9. Zhao Rei. It's not who shoots the three really for China, it's how many of their players shoot it. And the answer is pretty much all of them.
Yeah, pretty much. They've hit 12 points from outside, 6 points from inside the arc, and that's the issue for Indonesia. China are very well balanced on the offensive end. There's a replay, Wong going inside for the score, and this is the problem at the moment for Indonesia, that China are able to score from outside, from inside. They're running Indonesia ragged on the defensive end. They scored 20 points in the first 5 minutes. Indonesia need to slow this pace down. They are not a high-scoring team. been averaging 66 points a game. They need a low-scoring contest. And China at the moment are really forcing things forward. Yoato now being harassed. Is he going to get over the half? He does to Bolden just about. But they burned the 10 seconds off the shot clock for Indonesia already.
Well, here they are, Grajica putting it on the deck. And jump shot missed. Now the pass. And they've got a foul on Yoato.
Interesting to see this one. He looks like he's trying to body. Let's look where his hands are. Yeah, it's just that left hand, I think. Swings him out of the way. And this is the China we were expecting to be here at the tournament. This is clearly the China we were expecting to be here. They have grown game after game after game, particularly their last game against Chinese Taipei. Against Chinese Taipei was a big step forward, and looks like they're going to make another one here today.
And the ball does go over to Indonesia.
Can play that level of defense every time the ball goes down to Zhou Qi, particularly without getting a foul called.
Oh, that's what you call Zhou Qi. Slam City here in J-Town, number 15.
And that is a dynamic they just don't have when he's not on the floor. They don't have that.
And it came so late. Unfortunate for the Indonesia defense, almost getting the steal. Zhou Qi is a different tower down there for Bolden to go up against. Oh, nice defense by Prastawa. Yoato and traveling on Indonesia.
Look at that lob and the finish. That's an out-of-bounds play straight out the coach's book and executed it to perfection. So hard to defend against, that really is. Single digits to go into the quarter break for me. Double digit lead for China is tough for them to come back from.
Well, look at the defense of Zhou Qi. All right. Out of bounds.
You know, in the pregame, I said to you, foul trouble for the front court could be an issue for Indonesia. And that's, I think, for me, the problem they've got right now is that Xaviero sitting off the floor with two fouls is making it very difficult for them to defend the paint. Bolden's doing what he can, but he can only do so much.
Long shot is good. Well, he made a lot of Lu Mingxian in this tournament. The lead's now 14. Doesn't seem like Indonesia played poorly enough to be down 14, but they are. And just like China got up on top of China's Taipei,
going to be a long way back if Indonesia don't put the brakes on this now.
I think you're right. I don't think Indonesia will play poorly. I think China will play really, really well in this first quarter. They've come out almost with a chip on their shoulder, it feels like, that they're going to come and show that they are, you know, absolutely medal contenders, that they almost feel affronted that they're having to qualify for the quarterfinals.
Stalin missing from three, and goes from back to worse. He hasn't shot it well in this tournament. Trapman gives it back to Indonesia.
Yeah, that was just lazy footwork. That was training. That was like he was in practice where you just catch the ball, take a couple of steps, and then go into your offense. And they're the kind of mistakes that they need.
Bolden turns, that is out. Behind the back, Joe Chi, that is beautiful basketball.
This truly is. This is the China we were expecting from game one. We didn't have them really for the first three games, but they're making up for it right now. Their stock is going up every single possession.
Kostala into the paint, bounce pass Bolden. Jin brings it up, Jin grab it. Now Suns, a 16-point advantage. It's 11 points for Indonesia. They've hit a cold spell. Back to Joe Chi, and boy, they can't put a foot wrong right now.
They really can't. The telling stat for me right now is that Marques Bolden has 3 points. He has not hit a shot inside the arc in this first quarter. He's averaging 22 points a game. He needs to establish in the low post. They need to go a little bit almost caveman on this game.
Bahita tries to throw it back to Agassi, who thought, and now patience will win out, and China will hold it for the last shot in complete command. Nightmare scenario for Indonesia. On the spin, as Son gets in, misses. So, it's kind of taken some of the life out of the arena. There's no doubt about that. China head over to the bench. They lead it 29-11 at the end of the first quarter.
Yeah, and China have been near unstoppable. 5 from 7 from outside in that first quarter, shooting better from outside than they did inside. Indonesia not getting anything going at the moment, not leaning on their assets like Bolden the way they need to if they're going to come away with a win. And it's a long way back, not an impossibility. There's still tons of time left, but for me, Indonesia, they have to go a little bit old school. They just need to have to build Bolden into the low post. What's the reason that China have dominated? Because they got foul trouble on Javiero. I think the way that they could get foul trouble on the likes of Zhou or Wong is by going into the low post. Let Bolden try and back them down, draw them into contact. But ultimately, they just can't carry on letting China dictate the way the game's being played, which is what's happened in the first 10 minutes.
Well, the way this is working out for China, if you think about such a difficult start, losing to Korea on opening night, then winning by the skin of their teeth in their next game, they have perhaps had a chance to survive, and now they're like, well, okay, let's grow in this tournament. You know, they're going to maybe peak at the right time. They're peaking.
It's going to sound like a weird comment, but when you see this, it actually feels like China moving into this qualification game is a good thing because they'll get more workout.
Courtside 1891, scanning the barcode, and you get the stream, schedule, scores from the FIBA Asia Cup and international basketball. It's all great stuff. Yep. Yeah, I agree with you. I think the extra game,
I think it's good for them.
Strange thing is, you look at the other teams that had to go into qualification for the quarterfinals, like the Philippines, like New Zealand. You have to ask yourself that question. Japan, and boy, who drives in? And look at that. Jack comes in and gets the rebound. Turns it over.
At the moment for Indonesia, what they're trying to do, that, you know, they want to get the ball to bowl, and there's no two ways about that. If it seems to be off some perimeter dribble, stop that action, just get down to the low post, let them establish, let them body and try and lock out a low post position, because this working at the top isn't working.
Well, they almost turned it over there. Agassi. Oh, those heights.
Bolden isn't going anywhere near the ring right now. When that shot went up, he was on the three-point line. This isn't a healthy structure. This has to change for Indonesia, or China is just going to completely railroad them into a huge loss.
Zhao fouled by Wisnu.
To a certain degree, that's what Wisnu brings to Indonesia right now. Just comes in a bit of a body, plays a bit of physical defense, can give up some of his fouls, save some of the other team members.
China makes the first. China go up 32-11. The Euro comes back. Now it's. Doesn't matter if he's got two fouls, three fouls, he's got to have it in the game. He's trying to get back into the game.
Yeah, there'll be nothing left to save from four if he doesn't come in and make an impact.
Jai was over the line. I've seen that a lot in this competition. The shooter going over the line too early. Zapatera impounded. So you talked about the guard play before the game, and it's a lot to take on for somebody like Zapatera against this Chinese team, that pressure. So he's going to come out, and with Yantin Taja is going to come in.
At the moment, it just feels like they're trying to find someone that can, you know, just be stable at the point guard position. We've put up with all this huge pressure from China, and I'm not sure there is someone in the roster at the moment that can cope with this level of defense.
For Hu Ming-Chen, the lead now 33-11.
They've got to go over those screens. The guards for Indonesia have to fight harder to get over the screens.
Ball goes through the legs of Bolden, and it's going from bad to worse. Jiang gets off. Zhou Qi kept it alive, and then Javier tapped it in by accident. And it's a stunned crowd. I think it's starting to sink in how big of a test this was at this FIBA Asia Cup for this team. There's just not much margin for error. And then Zhou Qi has definitely neutralized the impact of Marquez Bolden inside.
Yeah, he truly has. He's you know, locked Bolden out, and he's lost his confidence, and at the moment he's not a factor for Indonesia, and I never thought I'd be saying that this early in the game.
Who again, and China just slamming the door shut on Indonesia's chances of getting to the World Cup.
Yeah, ruthless, to say the least. And certainly not benevolent right now, but I don't blame them. You know, this is a tune-up game for them. If they've obviously got to win it, but they've got to get better as well.
Taja.
I don't think we've seen a more dominant opening 14 minutes, 13-minute performance from any team in this Asia Cup than this one.
Well, you figure how Indonesia, I mean, they really gave as good as they got against Australia for the first 15 minutes, and it's just kind of snowballed. And China had the capacity. We saw it happen against Chinese Taipei. Here's again, Hu hitting the three. We saw them against Chinese Taipei. They came right out, and they just got on top of Chinese Taipei, and it was just a mountain too big to climb back for Chinese Taipei. But it wasn't a mountain like this. This is, what is the biggest mountain in Indonesia for China? I mean, it's about that size right now. Zhai putting the D on Grajita. He's able to get the shot off, and it's good.
And at least
this time they got the mismatch that they were looking for, but there's too much time being spent dribbling the ball around the top of the key, trying to just wave off the Chinese defense. They've got to pass the ball to the wing so that they can put a pass into the low post.
Well, that's good defense by Wisnu. Kurelski break, and he's tripped up. Count it.
Nope. Peasants asking if that was not an unsportsmanlike. This was a great effort to get that shot off with time running down. So Rahita doing everything he can. Oh, nice pump fake by Wisnu.
Oh, and he's pulling hard.
And hopefully,
no one wants to see that.
It's not injured.
That's one in the ground, really hard flipping.
Ooh, he hit his head. That's a similar situation, only this time it was the defender.
He's sitting up though, he just looks a little bit dazed right now. They're gonna help him to his feet.
They should probably get him out of the game, shouldn't they? Of course, he's got.
Not a huge fan of that from Wisnu, if I'm honest. You know, no intention meant clearly from his play, but if you've knocked a player to the floor, you go and check he's all right. You know, maybe. When he gets up, you go and give him a little hand tap. And
well, you never know. They might be a bit naive to some of the do's and don'ts.
Potentially.
He's trying to find a way out of it for him. He makes the first. So he looks okay, Wong. Definitely would not want Wong falling on you. He's a very big man.
No, you wouldn't want to make an enemy of him either. To be honest, if I'm Wisnu now, I might get out of the way if he's in the lane trying to drive to the basket.
Wisnu was the player that didn't, honestly, did not impress me that much. But he's actually played okay tonight so far.
Yeah, he's been a few good spells across the tournament, nothing too consistent though.
Good.
It's just money in the bank every time he steps up now. His third three of the game, 3 from 5 from the field. He's been the most consistent for me out of all the Chinese players across this tournament.
They're 8 of 11 from 3-point range. But a team like China, with the size that they have, also shoots it well from 3-point range, it doesn't give you much of a chance.
No, it truly doesn't. And that's the thing with China. They have offensive threats throughout their entire roster. And in so many different ways, they can score on you.
And you have to give them credit. Xiao Rei drives and scores.
It just feels like slightly maybe this is a bit of a rude awakening for Indonesia and their fans, and almost kind of a welcome call to say welcome to the highest level of Asian basketball from China.
That was a great drive by Xiao Rei. Did you see how that was a strong that he took, and he was able to, he earned that celebration because he was able to finish through the contact.
And you can tell as well when you see Coach Lou sitting down, it's a good thing.
Rahita over to Sun, and another turnover. And the guard play from Indonesia has really struggled against China. China, if they win this, they will advance to take on Lebanon. It's hard to see that not happening right now, midway through the second quarter.
Yeah, the road back for Indonesia seems to be a very difficult one now.
Javiero stands, turns. The thing about China is usually they're the kind of team, the way we saw them come out against Korea and Chinese Taipei, is they like to come out effectively in the sporting parlance, hit you in the mouth.
Yeah.
And they didn't really do that to Indonesia today. They just kind of eased their way in, but just, you know, able to hit their shots.
just been an absolute lesson, it really has, and I'm sure there's plenty of other teams in this Asia Cup looking around thinking, man, China aren't really going to be ready for that big game. This is the first time they've stepped up.
So, in fact, the other one was on Wong, and there is Zapatero getting into it with Wong.
And Javiero as well. Javiero pushing the ball into Wong as he walks away. It's just completely unnecessary.
Yeah, well,
and Javiero, he's on two fouls. What are you doing?
Yeah.
Does your team really need that?
Yeah, that's all Javiero, unfortunately. He needs to learn.
And he's the 19-year-old. It didn't come in out, isn't it?
I'm sure if Pešić saw that, he would bring him out of the game immediately, because I would.
At least bring him to the side and explain to him it's not acceptable. If I see any more, you're going to sit down.
But on the other hand, you kind of like it in a way, if you know what I mean.
The aggression's needed, you know, and the insult that he will be feeling right now because his team are trailing by so many, you need to channel that. It's just channel it in the right direction.
Yeah, he needs to understand he can play hard, but you do have the two fouls. It takes your breath away, doesn't it?
I mean,
you just gotta give credit. They just lights out China. 9 of 12 from 3-point range.
You know, this is getting close to rivaling what Japan did in Syria. And some seriously impressive shooting performances in this Asia Cup.
Rohita, Sun, China. Getting another three, count it!
Jang!
It really is. I mean, 10 of 13 from 3-point range. China are absolutely on fire. Leading to another timeout for Indonesia.
Threats that can shoot the ball from outside. Gu obviously is going to steal the headlines. 4 from 6 from outside, up to 14 points. So, rightfully so, getting a huge amount of applaudits. But it's just been relentless from China. Not just on the outside, on the inside as well. And Zhou Qi's been in the game. He's been dominant. Very impressive.
Yeah, this is a beatdown. There's no other way to describe it. Doesn't mean that Indonesia can't come back and play better. You'd like to see them compete. At 34 points right now, late in the first half. The comeback from this deficit would be an epic comeback, to put it mildly.
I think it would break quite a few records if it did.
Boy, how about that? Wong. Wong is pretty tough, and then when he starts spinning his way in there, hustles back to get the basketball. Face challenge, you'd like to take away their inside game. At least. Oh, boy.
Oh,
look at the quality
beautiful.
Of the big foul.
That is
great footwork from Wong Jilin.
And for me, it's a lost art. That back to the basket, just using your pivot and your body movement, so controlled, such precision, really phenomenal.
And that's not really necessary from Wong. I guess he wants to keep the ball away from Marquez Bolden. So three fouls on Wong Jolin, but he's gonna.
And that's a positive sign, you know.
That check it out.
At least they're going back to the basket. And this is what I was talking about. They can't just use the perimeter. Just go old school, nice and simple. You don't have to run anything too fancy. Just run something, you know, a cross screen or something that enables Bolden to post up relatively close to the basket and at least test the big men of China to see if they can play defense against him. Because in the first half, they've not tested it. He scored 3 points so far. He's averaging 22. It's, you know, he's not been a factor in this game on that end of the floor.
We'll see if China continue to pile on the pressure or if Indonesia can mount just a little bit of a fight back here at the end of the first half. Okay, he's to fouling. Chao Ray out on the perimeter. Anymore, they'll put China on the line. China already over 11. Oh, what a nice little over the shoulder pass back to Joe Chi. He's no ordinary Joe, that's for sure. But that was all Chao Ray. He's been terrific. Postara. Like I saw him, Bolden. And despite Sun running at him, Bolden kept his cool and nailed the three. Side again to Bolden if you want. That is about as frustrating as it gets for Indonesia.
But for me, that's the difference in the levels. You've got Indonesia at the moment trying to create some offense on the fly. You know, Bolden telling Joato to cut the baseline and Plastawa passing it to where he was. And then you look at the Chinese offense, they know exactly when and where their teammates are cutting, how they're cutting, why they're cutting. That's the difference.
So the foul puts China on the line. Oh, Brandon Joato.
Players, they almost look a little bit shell-shocked right now. I think they knew it was going to be a tough game. You know, they were clearly ready for a big challenge against a very impressive, deep Chinese team, but I don't think they expected China to come out this way.
Yeah, I guess their saving grace is the fact that they are facing one of the best teams in Asia. Doesn't make it any easier, especially because you're home and especially because you know you can play better. 35-point lead. Postara pulls up at the elbow. Well, you think about, you know, they're building towards the World Cup, not just this FIBA Asia Cup. They want to have a good tournament in next year. And ball batted out. Shot clock violation. Goes back over 12.2 seconds. I guess they would be popular, you know, here in Indonesia if they were to come back. We've seen a lot of fans from China.
course, they would be popular in Australia as well. They've got a lot of Chinese fans, a lot of Chinese people living there. And Costala drives in, misses the layup. Son, look at how he's able to get up and hit that three-pointer. Unbelievable.
Well, that just puts an exclamation mark on a thoroughly dominating performance for China.
Wow. Breathtaking. The beatdown is halfway done. China cruising here in Jakarta. They go to the changing rooms, leading 59-21 over Indonesia.
The ball.
Well, I suppose we came here expecting a little bit more competitive game from Indonesia, the way they had taken on Australia, but China came out and really just tore into this team.
Yeah, they really did, and I think the biggest signal for the demolition is the fact that four Chinese players are already on double digits and we're only halfway through this game. Both inside and outside players as well. The onslaught has been from every single part of the court. It's not been a three-point barrage. That has happened, but they've also dominated inside, you know, eight offensive rebounds. It's been a huge performance for China, and it's been the performance I think a lot of us were expecting from the get-go. I don't think we were expecting so long for them to come through with a big performance like this.
Well, Sun has an engine that runs hot, and so does this guy, Gu, who just finds his spots, hits his three-pointers, and pours on the agony for whatever team he's playing. He's got 11 points. He's perfect from three-point range, 3 of 3. Excuse me, he's perfect from three-point range. He's got 12 points, 4 of 6. Well, that's not perfect, is it? He's near perfect. Feels like he's perfect. 4 of 6. Hu Mingqing is perfect. 3 of 3. So those two guys really have been tough. Xiao Rei, obviously, multiple three-pointers for him. You would expect. Sun always putting pressure on the opponent with his pace, with his intensity, with his playmaking. He's got 6 assists.
And it's interesting for Coach Du now. I know, you know, as a coach, you never want to have nothing to say. But what can you say? Same again. There's very few areas that you could look at this performance from China and say, oh, they could do a bit more of this, or a bit more pressure on the ball, or better, you know, better boxing out. What? There's nothing. They've literally put in a perfect performance. And you wonder what Coach Pezic is saying. You can tell that they put in a great performance because they've been in the locker room about 2 minutes and come back out again. Coach Pezic now has a huge job on his hands. Even if the win is away, what more can you do?
Who will you become when the moment arrives and you're carrying the expectations of an entire nation, representing your people and their dreams? The colorful faces in the streets, the screaming fans in the stands. It's time to make your move. All eyes on you, all hope, all heart. Because when you win for all.
Yeah.
spins, gets down the baseline, puts it up and throws it down. Al Hallmarche just looking up at the big fella. And they get over some time. Navarro.
This is a Navarro flush.
Hafiz just falls asleep. I mean, his turnovers are just going to be, oh, look at this, another one! Ezzedine! That must be what they practice. Oh, boy, Alexa take it, and now the break for Ravenna. Oh, what a play by Ravenna! And then Davidson fouls. The chance for a three-point play.
What a slick pass that was from number 28.
And that is great team offense. Campbell just looking for the backdoor cut from Aram, and Aram timing it perfectly.
Jang gets it to who? Back to Jang for three. The offensive rebound, and he's fouled. Can you believe it? Goo!
He's been pretty quiet in the second half, but what a time to wake up. Absolutely unbelievable.
Coming up on the 1 minute mark here. And
Barry goes in, and boy, does he put the Saudi on the poster.
You feel kind of bad for Al Hawsawi.
He'll be
a bit naive.
He'll be having nightmares for weeks on that one.
I guess that's not to pick up a third foul. Freddie. Oh, he was going in for a dunk.
That's great defense leading to fast break offense.
Oh, boy, look at that passing. Tominaga. Good.
Showing the 3-point sign.
Tough quarter. He just hasn't received the ball where he wants it. Most of his points have come from outside of the perimeter. And yes, he can shoot the ball well. He is a stretch big, but he needs the ball back to the basket so he can do some work. You know, he can cause some foul trouble, some fatigue for the other team. At the moment, he's really been no impact in the paint on the offensive end. Defensively, he's tried his hardest, but he has been minimized by China. You have to say they've done a great job on reducing the threat that he poses.
China, this guy just continues to impress. Gu is, wow, he's just, he rarely misses. He's been good in every game. And who knows,
Maybe by the end of the tournament, he'll be on the All-Star 5 because he gives them a perimeter threat like no other, although they do have other guys looking at the three-pointers, and that makes him even more dangerous because when he's open, he's knocking them down.
He's been the most consistent player. You know, they've relied on him through every single game. That game against Bahrain where it all fell apart, he was the one that stepped up, had 22 points, 5 rebounds, did a huge job. You think about it, that game, Blues are out. And he was the player, you know, one of the key players that stepped up when others were losing their heads. For me, yeah, Mr. Consistency and the superstar here today from downtown.
China leading 59-21 over Indonesia here at halftime of this qualification for the quarterfinals, and teams are out in their shoot-arounds, and Indonesia, obviously the carrot for them to win was not only to advance, to stay alive in the FIBA Asia Cup, which they're hosting, to get to the quarterfinals, but also to punch their ticket for the FIBA Basketball World Cup. And I guess the reality is, you know, as a basketball nation, a basketball program, they're not as far along as a lot of the other teams that are here, and they've been able to paper over some of the cracks with the addition of Marquez Bolden. Their Michael Javier has been terrific. You know, nobody's questioning their heart and perhaps their potential. But the reality is, you know, they are not among those elite nations. And if it were that easy, any team could come out and win games and get to the World Cup. You've got 32 teams that'll be in the World Cup. Indonesia wanted to be one of them, especially since they're the host nation. But at least they've shown in this competition that they're kind of moving in the right direction. And one bad result, even if this turns out to be a bad result, should not make people think that this isn't a country that doesn't have that potential.
No, potential is exactly the right word. When that initial target was set and was kind of set as the barrier that they needed to overcome, this idea of getting to the quarterfinal and get their World Cup spot, I think most people in world basketball was like, that is a really big ask. And Indonesia have almost got there. You know, they've gone up against a really tough Chinese team. They still have 20 minutes to pull off what would be probably one of the most amazing upsets of all time. So it's looking like they're going to bow out at this stage. But they've really impressed me. They are far, far further on than where I thought they would be. Marquez Bolden certainly helps. You know, he's only 24 years of age. If he can stay in the program and commit to the program long term, I think that will help them. It provides role models for some of the young players like Xaviero coming through. So they can't be too downbeaten by, you know, this situation they find themselves in. They should take it as a positive of how competitive they've been.
Yeah, when I heard what the requirements were for them to get to the FIBA Basketball World Cup, to get to the quarterfinals of the FIBA Asia Cup, I said, not going to happen.
Yeah.
I said that immediately. But they've been so good at this FIBA Asia Cup. I thought coming into today, okay, in China are huge favorites, but you know what? Indonesia, they could put it into performance and it could be interesting. But
China have a bad day, Indonesia have a good day. This is a lot closer game. But China certainly aren't having a bad day today. This is one of their best.
Very fast, coming under the basket.
But yeah, for China now, they just can't be complacent, carry on executing. And they need to look at this as part of their building process. You know, clearly, outside a freak second half, they're going to book their spot in the quarterfinal where they'll face Iran, which will be a much sterner task.
One of the rivals in Asia in recent times has been more successful for Iran rather than for China. So, this is again, you look at this team, this Indonesia team, and they need to look at this as part of the process. Come out and play hard. Play every second, play every possession. That's all you can do, like, in this. Take the mental stuff out and try to play basketball. Get on the FIBA Asia Cup app. What a fantastic app it is. Takes you all the news, all the stats, the results of the FIBA
Asia Cup as well as they just scanned that barcode. Strongly recommended.
And the nice thing we've had here throughout these games in Indonesia is this crowd. They have been so supportive for their team in the good times, in the win, in the tough games, the losses. They have continued to support their team in such a positive way. They've not got on their backs, they've not been negative. They've just tried to lift them up, and it's a wonderful city, and the World Cup is honored to be here next year.
Absolutely. Second half action underway in Jakarta. China starting with possession, leading 59-21. Qualification for the quarterfinal. Zhou Qi getting blocked. And Mikhail, the Kazakhstan referee, calls the foul. I think he got him swinging down with his arm.
Yeah, it's the right call. Bolden gave up on his footwork on that final phase of that play and just reached across. And Zhou Qi's wingspan, well, he can almost reach outside the building from the paint, so he's able to lift it away. And if anyone's forgotten anything and left it in the locker room, it's all right. We can send Zhou Qi's arms to go and get it.
Zhou Qi, possibly the talent that most people outside of China and Asia would identify as the biggest player of China right now. The one with the most potential, the one that you would like to have in your team, maybe. And it's Claro Xaviero, and that's exactly why he is a SWAT machine, a rim protector. And you're only going to have, you're going to have to dunk it. This is just not going to be here. Not in your house, he says.
Yeah, when you're going up against him, you've got to draw body contact. It's that simple. You're going to have to go into him, draw body contact. Otherwise, he is just going to bat that one away.
Charles Ray takes a shot to the face. So again, the winner advances to take on Lebanon, who have been terrific. Charlie goes ready to pick back to Bolden. And good hustle from Prastawa. Puts it up. And Xaviero couldn't rebound the miss. Sun makes it even more painful because he hits the three-pointer. What a performance.
Phenomenal. But Bolden shouldn't have to be chasing that out after that block. There should be someone rotating round to keep Bolden in the paint to protect the rim.
There's Bolden crashing the boards. And foul. China, of course, trying to win this FIBA Asia Cup for the first time since 2015, when they hosted the event and beat Philippines in the final.
They're certainly determined to improve on the fifth place they had in 2017.
Yeah, that was a subpar performance, without doubt. Bahita missing, and Gelato with the rebound. Foul call on Xiao Ray. So he's picked up a couple of quick fouls.
And China looking a little bit more complacent in the second half. It's not the same Chinese team that we saw in the first half. And that's a great example. At the start of that drive from Joato, way too much separation. And that's why Xiao Ray ends up picking up the foul, because he has to create contact at some point, and he creates it too late.
Xu Jin comes into the game, number 30. Another guard. Also coming in, number 23, Hu Ming Shin. So the lead is 40 right now for China. Set the pick, yeah. And Indonesia were lost after that.
Yeah, absolutely. Gu setting that huge screen, and that just opened up the backdoor cut. Just patience at the top, though, waiting for it to happen.
Brahita this time has the ball smacked out of bounds by Sun.
And you can see the difference in the level. Grahita coming around that screen. It wasn't sharp, it wasn't snappy. He didn't move himself straight into a jump stop and explode up. You can see that's the level they need to raise themselves to.
Toronto for three. Bolden tried to get it, but Gu comes down with a board. No, no look past Sun. How about that by Sun? And then Joji just kind of puts the exclamation mark on it. Gu Mingxin with the bump.
And I like that for Sun. If you see your big man, get out and run. Try and reward him if you can. You want to incentivize your front court players to stretch out and finish the ball like that.
Sun Mingwei with 8 assists after that pass. Sun Mingwei, just 26 years of age. Pastawa. Duato. And Bolden able to get the rebound. Pastawa. Sun Mingwei again in transition. This could be another assist for him, and it is! Xu Jian coming in and pouring in the points.
And you can hear within the crowd as well, you know, as much as majority of them are here for Indonesia. I think they're pretty impressed with this Chinese performance as well.
Grahita. Well, you can get demolitions like this all over the world, not just in Asia, but it happens in Africa, it happens in Europe, it happens in the Americas. Probably not as often in Europe, I wouldn't think. Grahita misses the first. I guess in Europe you actually have a level, you know, a pre-qualification to get into the qualifiers. Like so many countries that are so competitive. So in that sense, Indonesia, well, they can really grow, and they can grow quickly, I think, in Asia if they really put their minds to it and they dedicate themselves to it and they continue to work on developing good young talent.
I certainly think the Asia Cup being here will have helped that process. Seeing so many people coming into the stands to watch these games, coming away inspired by what they've seen, and potentially see professional basketball as a career opportunity for them.
Bolden, how about that? You know, they will have been inspired by Javiero.
Yep.
But also players of other teams, you know, big and small. You know, it's not just the big guys that are always getting the job done. So Kawamura of Japan have a big game against Syria.
For Indonesia now, it's just not to give up on the game. Keep going. You know, your crowd are here to see you. Just take every last second on the floor, enjoy it, relish these moments.
Pastawa be frustrated. That's a layup that he would expect to make. Quickly, Diputra got a tap on that. Goes out of bounds.
And this is the power of China for me. Zhou Qi heading to the bench. Yeah. And then Angelin comes in. It's just relentless. Very different style of players. But the quality is just immense in that front court for China. It's immense through the full 12, to be fair. Back court, front court, doesn't really matter. They've got world-class talent everywhere.
Coco de Putra knocks it away. Three-point shot, Giuato. You know, you look at the potential rivals of China, Haddadi and Iran, they've got good size.
Oh, there's plenty of good bigs in this tournament for China to go off against, that's for sure.
Zhai Wong with the rebound. Chu Jin, and it bounces over.
Yeah, there's some interesting battles ahead for China if they progress through the tournament. You know, on their side of the bracket, obviously they face Lebanon in that quarterfinal. Just correction, I said Iran earlier. They would face potentially either Iran, Jordan, or Chinese Taipei in the semi-final. So yeah, there's plenty of good front court players that they could still potentially face in this tournament. And I've been so impressed by China. I was worried when we first saw those first couple of games. You know, they weren't in sync, they weren't playing good team basketball. They struggled in that game against Bahrain, and you saw their frustrations go a little bit too far. They looked a lot better against Chinese Taipei, but still not to the level we know they can play. And then today, they have looked like that world-class side that we know China are.
Song for the first time kind of makes a mistake. He's claiming the ball. No, here we go, look at it again.
It hit him afterwards, look. It's off the side of his face.
You can hear the crowd, but getting into it! And Bolden finally able to throw it down and earn a trip to the line. Taking his frustration out on the rim and on Jai.
That's just a nasty dunk. That really is aggression. Just bangs it down. Bolden isn't the most aggressive player. He plays with a smile on his face, but you're right. That was about 25 minutes of frustration taken out on the iron that time.
Really kind of the first really good moment in this game for Indonesia. Because they have a bit of power to it.
And they've outscored China 12 to 11 now in this quarter. They'll take some confidence from that.
Wong brings it down, did not get it off in time. I suppose when you look at the potential of China, you remember the Asian qualifiers when they took on Australia in Australia, in Melbourne. Zhou Qi held his own. He had 16 points, 17 rebounds, but Australia still won that game, 76-69. So here is the basket by Prestal. You can see this Indonesia team. They're like, okay, we got 13 minutes. Let's just at least see how close we can get.
And Coach Du is screaming, why are you not fouling them? Why are you not playing more aggressive?
And Ray gets it to drop.
The crowd silent. All the air was taken out of the arena on that little jumper from Ray.
Giuato. To fouls. So Australia beat China twice in the Asian qualifiers. Hard to beat the team three times. It's basically just a little bit of change in the teams. Uh,
They really went off the rails against China in that fourth quarter, that second game.
Yeah, they absolutely collapsed. It was close all the way through to the fourth, and then Australia just dominated them.
That's nobody boxing out Wong, who really does get to the glass, gets to the boards.
But to be honest, in that fourth quarter, Dellavedova really took over that game. So he's not here. I think it's a lot closer than that scoreline suggests.
Bowled in! Slow to get up. China trying to get it before he gets back on defense. And Gu, and now a chance for Bowman, who's up ahead if they can find him. He's got it, lays it up and in. Another three-point play opportunity. Wong has done wrong. He's fouled. Look at where he takes off. Yeah, Wong just there slightly
turned his
late.
Shoulder in. Almost his instincts took over then, rather than taking Bolden fully on the chest as he drove past him. He just slightly turned his shoulder in to protect himself.
Walker's out, and Jiang hearing it from his coach. Look at the fans. What do you call those things they're beating? Indonesia actually winning this quarter 19-15.
Yeah, doing a great job, the fans here. Chance of MVP for Bolden.
So Joe Chi comes back into the game to kind of reclaim control of the situation. China obviously with a huge lead, but Indonesia playing better at the moment. Fajita guarding Hu Ming-Chin. Oh boy, got away with one, I think. He reached in. To whose credit, he didn't complain. Pastawa. Grajita, Bolden for three. Oh, rims out. Unlucky. You can hear the disappointment in the crowd.
You can. They're fully invested in this one.
Good from downtown in J-town, and he's off target.
And this is the only concern within this game for China. They're looking to panic a little bit.
Three. Pastawa misses it badly.
He's trying to be a little bit too much of the hero there, Pastawa. That wasn't the right choice for his team.
Jiang, and then he hits the three. So a 6-point swing.
China have looked rattled in this phase of good play from Indonesia, and signals to that mentality as well. They had issues in that game with the two ejections. You wonder how mentally tough they are.
Duato, wide open, count it! That's a good point. And great defense at the end.
And they're getting after Zhao Rei now. Fans have been magnificent.
They get an open one from Jiang, and Jiang gets blocked by Bolden. Can't believe he got to that. Well, they've given the fans something to clap about. How about that for Indonesia? They cut the deficit. China's still in command, 77-44.
That's huge, though, for Indonesia. They won that quarter by 5 points. All of their shooting numbers starting to move up, but most of the damage they're doing going towards that basket. 11 from 14 from the free throw line helps as well. And Coach Du now has something to talk about, now has something that his team needs to correct.
I think what they showed in that quarter, and probably what they can show in the fourth as well, is that if they had only started better,
yeah,
this would have been a more competitive game. It's
absolutely
easier said than done against China, because China tend to start fast.
Yeah, and also I feel that, you know, I won't say this too loud because we've got a lot of Indonesian fans around us. I feel that China took their foot off the gas a little bit in that
third quarter.
They just took their eye
off the game. They weren't fully focused. They weren't continuing to push through. But you have to give credit to Indonesia because they made it happen. You know, they took that chance. They took that complacency and put some points on the board. So it's a great job in the third quarter by Indonesia. And as much as the game is out of grasp right now, there's still a huge amount of play for in this 10 minutes. You have got a huge number of fans in the crowd that are being entertained and are falling in love more and more with basketball and, more importantly, with their national team.
I think that's the key. It's Indonesia want to lead. They want to make sure in this last quarter that they give their best version of themselves.
Oh, fully. If they can go away and say we won the second half, yeah, against one of the powerhouses of Asian basketball. Remember, China are number one on the medal table in Asia Cup. You know, they are pretty much perennial World Cup attendees. They push themselves there. That is a huge statement from Indonesia and will engage not just the fans, but policymakers and all these other people that are intrinsic to them building a strong national team program.
Fourth quarter underway. Here, China still on top. And it's Indonesia with possession. Indonesia trying to keep the momentum going. Oh, he was tempted. Shot clock winding down. And Bolden took on Jochi. Had to take a difficult shot. Hassan quickly to hustles down. Collects the pass and puts it up.
And I like that transition. It was staggered. You had a couple of players running hard. You then have a trailer in the shape of Gu and gets the score.
Pistawa missing. I think you begin to appreciate what the absence of Jochi for that Korea game meant for China, having watched him play the last couple of games.
Yeah, truly meant a lot. So, particularly as Wong was out of the game as well, so the two frontline bigs didn't play. But don't take anything away from Fan. He did a great job across those first two games where he was needed. Hasn't been seen since. And on Indonesia's side, I'm surprised we haven't seen Xaviera.
I was about to say, but you look across the board and the numbers aren't as good and they're playing well all of a sudden. So you don't just put him in because he's Xaviera. Jang.
I think we'll see him soon, though.
Yeah, I think so.
Coach Bezic will try and bring him in, or should look to bring him in.
Maybe he's forgotten about it. Wisnu, however, has not been forgotten. He's about to come in. It was the baseline drive and the foul by Jawato. Okay, now he comes.
Yeah, it's a wise move. They're struggling to defend the paint now. You can see Jawato having to play some catch-up defense ineffectively. Wisnu and Xaviera will come back in. And if Xaviero can channel that emotion he's clearly feeling, understandably so. I can't imagine at the age of 19 being in this situation, how you cope with that, how you deal with that. If you can channel it positively, he could have a really big impact in this last 8 minutes and 16 seconds and send the fans home with some highlights that they won't forget in a long time.
The drop. 81-44. The referee just fell over. Well, it happens. I even fell over coming over tonight. Stumbled on the step. Where the referee fell.
They're on it, aren't they, with the mops?
Jang, pressure, puts it up. And the foul called on China on the rebound. So Bolden had such a difficult start to the game. They're struggling to get him involved. But even so, here early in the fourth quarter, Marquez Bolden has 19 points, two blocks to go with his five rebounds. I guess they'd like his rebounding numbers to be up.
He had a slow start, but he's certainly putting in the numbers now. I don't think that's the best look for him, though. Again, they need to look for him when he's back to the basket. It's much more effective.
Oh, wow. Good shooters get those rolls.
The basketball gods are looking down on him right now, that's for sure.
19 points for Drew. Might just be the best player in this game when you consider what he did early on when they took command.
Yeah, I think the timing of his contribution was key. You know, when the game was still in the balance, he was the player that stepped up and really put a big performance in.
So Joe Chi goes to sit back down. Wong, Jolene comes back in, number 14. Again, somehow he's able to get that shot off, and he gets it back and puts it up and in. He is so quick to the ball, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He keeps fighting, and that kept them in the tournament earlier in that game against Bahrain. Exactly that type of play kept their Asia Cup alive.
Just wonder if he's caught the eye of NBA scouts the way that he plays. There's a nice defensive play, but they get it back. Wisnu powers his way in, misses the layup. Gu again.
And he gets out and runs in transition. He knows he gets rewarded if he does, but Gu, yeah, 30 years old, so you wonder, during that career, when were they knocking on the door? Because I'm sure they were looking at him.
It's hard to believe. It's hard to believe that we're really just seeing him with China. Louis Scola went over already, like, I think it was his late 20s. Anyway, it doesn't matter if you're good enough. It doesn't matter what age you are. You can still play. And I'm sure his profile is going up and away back home in China. You need to have stars like that at home to draw the crowds in. And it's great that he plays at the Asian qualifiers and the FIBA Asia Cup. Oh boy, the ball thrown away. Wisnu and Zhao Rei joining each other. That's what I don't get about Zhao Rei and in one sense, Sun. I know that you have to have that killer instinct, but when you're up 44 points, it's kind of like you could tone it down just a little bit. But I guess that's the competitor in him. And now we're seeing the competitor in Zapatero.
Oh.
Well, it's not good enough. Xu Jian takes him to the hoop.
Just good footwork. Stayed with the play, and the quality throughout China's roster has been very, very impressive today. Going to certainly be an interesting quarterfinal against Lebanon. If China play at this level, I'm not sure Lebanon can stay with them, but it is a big if, you know. The deal with China in this tournament has just been that inconsistency.
Reach and the foul. I think with Lebanon, I'm really interested to see what tactics they'll bring to the table, how they're going to approach it. And if they shoot the basketball well, then it's anything is possible. Wisnu. And unfortunately for Indonesian fans, their team has kind of lost its way again here in the fourth quarter. They're being outscored 14 to nothing. And it slips over. Zapatero
is being a child right now. He needs to grow up. He needs to grow up and let go of the ball. It's being very, very silly. The crowd might like it, but it's not a trait that's going to get him very far as a pro baller if he doesn't change. As soon as you hear that whistle, just let go of the ball. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, this is letting his frustration get the better of him.
And that's why he's sat up on the bench for an awful lot of this game, because Coach Pejic can't trust him not to create issues like that.
All right, they've called,
I think, a double technical.
Yeah, double techs.
And season goes to the bench again. Pejic takes him out, refuses to tap Coach Pejic's hand, sensibly goes back. That would have cost him if he walked straight to the bottom of the bench in a move.
Who hits a long three? The China just, again, just pouring it on in the fourth quarter now. 17 to nothing. They've outscored them. Agassi fouled by Wu from behind.
And I'm pretty sure that run and that intensity that we've seen again in the final quarter comes off the back of Coach Duke, you know, calling them out in that third quarter huddle. I'm sure he's turned around to them and say, this is our problem. We lose our focus, we lose our drive. And that's fine when you're up by 40, 50 points. But if you get a 10-point lead, a 15-point lead against a good team, you cannot turn your brain off like that. You have to be fully engaged for the entire 40 minutes. Otherwise, you'll quickly find yourself at the wrong end of the result.
Conclusion here, the last 4 minutes, China closing in on 100. Xu follows up the foul that frustrated him with a three-pointer.
He's certainly taking advantage of the minutes he's getting on the floor. 11 points, played a little over 8 minutes. And that's the important thing. If you are one of those bottom of the bench players who's getting limited minutes, you have to make the most of them and almost try and prove your coach wrong. Demand more time.
Ooh, Wilson got it up. He's able to score. With fans in there, quite the same rim protector that Jochi is. Who how? Missing from long run. Saputera. So you go back and you look at Indonesia at this FIBA Asia Cup. They started with an 80-54 win over Saudi Arabia. And all of a sudden, people started to believe. And they had Jordan in a really close game. But ultimately, could not get it done. They lost that one by 9. Probably closer than the final score indicated. China had surpassed 100 points in this game with that shot from Jiang. And then Indonesia played really well against Australia, leading them until about halfway through the second quarter. But tonight, it has been a nightmare with the exception of the third quarter. So Huh gets a basket, his first two.
And for Indonesia now, not to forget all of the positives that they've had prior to today's game. Today's game is absolutely one you want to forget. There's no two ways about that. They've not you know, played where they can play. But they need to take the positives. They need to think back to all those big phases that they've had in key games and really build upon those for future qualification campaigns and future tournaments.
Oh, Agassi did a good job getting that off, and then Bolden goes in and taps it in. I don't think Dufin can have a problem with Fan, because he was actually playing quite well before the bigs came back, so he took him out. He's lost his rhythm. Ooh, boy. Zapatero got away with a short grab. Here's Wisniewski. Six points for Wisniewski.
And potentially for Wisniewski, it's going to be one of his potentially last Asia Cups. You know, 34 years of age, will he be here for the next one? Maybe not. Not a bad way to go out, though. Not the game he would have wanted to go out in, for a home tournament where his team have really engaged the Jakarta population.
Zapatero, short. Push called on number 27, Fu Hao. Coming in, Kosasi. Also coming in, number 12, Mohamed Noor.
Final minute of the game now. China have looked so impressive throughout the game. This is the China that I think everyone was expecting to see.
Fans in. Stuck with it. And Noor, it's a three to get the crowd on their feet.
Well, there's many more superlatives that I can use for this Chinese performance. Bar a little hiccup in the third. He's been relentless against Indonesia. Point to prove, and a point has been made.
Well, that was a slick move by Fu Hao. Showing you how it's done. One of those bright green shoes. That's the final 12 seconds of the FIBA Asia Cup for Indonesia. Vincent Kosasi. And that's going to be it. Great job by China. They came out with the right approach today. Focused, determined, knowing they had to start getting it done the way, the China way. And Indonesia were in their path and got flattened in the first half. There was no way back. Well, they did show some hope in the third quarter, winning that frame, Indonesia. But ultimately, China cruised to a 108-58 victory.
Yeah, big performance from China. It's exactly what they needed. I think this extra game has been highly beneficial for them. Rather than almost going straight through to the quarters, this has helped. It's another tuning game for them. They haven't had a stable roster. This is only game two where they've had their full 12 available to them. And wow, if that's what they can do with a consistent roster. Look at the statistics, 18 from 32 from outside, 10 from 14 from the field, and Indonesia just struggled throughout. Offensively, they were limited by China impressively. China dominating the boards, playing great team offense. There's just not many negative things coming out of the game for China. Gu leads them with 23 points. He was phenomenal in really important points of the game. And Bolden checks out of the tournament with 21.
Thank you.
Well, Gu just got it going early on, just started pouring in the points, hitting the three-pointers, ended up hitting five on the night. He had 23 points and just was absolutely sensational, set the tone. Even on the shots that he didn't make, he was quick to the basketball, put him up and in, and he will be a key player for China over the last three games.
Yeah, he really will. Just picking up his TCL Player of the Game award, rightfully so. A big, big game for him. It's going to be important for the rest of the tournament. But the thing that's most impressive about this Chinese team was just how every single player came on and really, really put in a phenomenal performance. Five players in double digits. Jiang just missing out by a single point. Sun Wang missing out by 2 points. Just phenomenal. All 12 players on the floor. All 12 players scoring. And bar a little hiccup in the third quarter where they took their eye off the game, it was an incredible performance from China and one that will, you know, worry some of the other teams. They won't want to face China now. I'm sure, you know, Lebanon will be looking at this thinking it's not going to be an easy quarterfinal. They potentially have the game as actually underdogs, Lebanon, even though they qualified directly.
I think everybody knew beforehand that China was a contender.
Yeah.
Certainly for the spot on the podium, and with Zhou Qi, they're a possible title, Asia Cup title winner, something they haven't won since 2015 when they hosted it. But Australia are going to be a force. Lebanon, let's don't look past them. They've had a great Asia Cup, and I'm really intrigued to see how they're going to approach this game. They've shot it well every single game. So those, you know, there's going to be some, there are going to be a couple of hurdles for this China team, and the only one they need to concern themselves with right now is the Lebanese, the Cedars.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Plenty of smiles on their faces right now, and understandably so. They've put in a good performance. But looking down these brackets, it's not an easy ride for them. And it's setting up to be a great closeout to the Asia Cup.
So 108-58, China win it over Indonesia. Next, we have Jordan, Chinese Taipei. And of course, tomorrow, Japan against the Philippines. And then New Zealand taking on Syria. China perhaps a little wounded from their start to this tournament, but with Zhou Qi back in the frame, they showed what they are made of the last couple of games, including tonight when they put paid to the hopes of Indonesia advancing to the quarterfinals to reach the FIBA Basketball World Cup. Now it's all about China and Lebanon.